Jerome Miller's back.
Oh.
Now, obviously, this guy's ban ended in October. I'm actually shocked that it's taken until October for him to kind of find a home.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Eddie Hearn done an interview, I think, in Saudi Arabia. I think I heard him, or he done an interview where he said that Jerome Miller did want to sign to Matchroom and DAZN, but Eddie Hearn was like, he can't because of the situation.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if I believe that or not. But he's now signed with Top Rank, so Jerome Miller is back. I mean, what do you make of that? It's not even been a year since the fucking AJ fight was supposed to happen.
Well, what I find amazing is you look at this. I think Jerome Miller, he has failed before, prior to
I think that was, was that a kickboxing event? I think it might have been a kickboxing event, or even a boxing event, something.
One or the other.
Yeah.
He failed that, and then he fails for, you know, HGH, everything in this one, and he gets 6 months. And we look at Dylan White, who took that jacked 3D back a couple of years ago. He got a two-year ban, and then when the UCAD situation, the summer went, they were talking about 6-7 years.
Yes.
I mean, like,
it's crazy. It's, I remember crazy. That guy that fought Danny Garcia recently, the one that bit Danny Garcia.
Yeah.
He's got a year ban for the bite, and they've suspended, withheld his money. And you got this fucking little fat fucker, no disrespect to fat people, by the way, Jerome Miller taking EPO, HGH, and I can't remember, Juradol.
I think it was Juradol.
And he's got 6 months, and now he's back, signed with Top Rank, and he'll be earning some of that.
Yeah,
because Top Rank with this ESPN deal now, they're getting paid over there.
And I think I made a video about Jerome Miller signing with Top Rank, and I said, like, this is a man who went around accusing Anthony Joshua of being on, you know, this, that, and the other. And then he popped up.
Quite funny, actually.
It is, actually.
Yeah, it's quite funny. I guess the thing with Jerome Miller, and this is probably where I'm a hypocrite, is that I think fights against Chisora and fucking Dylan White was awesome.
That's the thing.
I hate myself for saying that.
It's like that against, even like if I look at someone like Povetkin, like I look at him, well, maybe not so much now because I think he slowed down a lot.
Done well though against Michael Hunter.
Done very well against Michael Hunter. I think he's on his last legs.
But
I look at guys like them who've, you know, failed drugs tests. I love watching them. Like, when I watch this is Jerome Miller,
we're all hypocrites, aren't we?
I'm tuning in.
We're all hypocrites, to be honest. If Canelo fights tomorrow, I'm tuning in.
Oh, exactly.
If it's pay-per-view, I'll probably find a stream or pay my money. Probably would, isn't it? Billy Joe Saunders, I'll tune in. Tyson Fury's got the issue as well. Everyone seems to sweep under the carpet. I'll tune in. And I guess that's the problem. They know we as fans are not going to tune out.
No.
Like, you know, all of us that moan online and fuck this, fuck, we're still going to tune in.
And we can say what we want. And we know Jerome Miller, he is what he is. You know, he's failed these drug tests. He's done all this. He's gave it all this. And then come back to bite him. We're still going to watch him.
But that's the issue. It's not up to us. If they don't put him on, we can't watch. So if he gets a two-year ban, none of us are going to be crying at home.
No.
If he gets the ban, we won't watch. If he doesn't get a ban, we'll watch. So I do blame the sanctioning bodies. I blame everyone else that's going to be involved with getting him back his license. Blame Top Rank, blame Bob Arum. Can't blame the fans for tuning in.
No.
That's the issue. You can't blame the fans.
No, no, but it's just, I think that's the way it's going. Like, and to me, it's like, how are you going to deter fighters from, you know, taking all these PEDs? If you think of it like this.
Good question. It's
a 6 month ban.
If it was 6 months, and I know that motherfucker, I'm taking the way he's taking.
It's a 6 month ban. I mean, like, if you're a top level fighter, you really are likely to fight twice a year anyway.
Yeah.
So a 6 month ban, that's just a normal kind of routine, just break from camp.
Yeah.
If you think about it in that context, and then start 6-8 week camp before your fight, and you're good to go, you're back, suspension's done.
You've got to be unbelievably mentally strong to not take a PED in boxing nowadays. And that sounds awful, but I do believe that in a sport where, like, I spoke to Gabriel Montoya a few years back, who's very high or very known in sort of the sort of ratting out cheats in boxing, so much so that he's been banned by some promoters from turning up to boxing events. And I asked him, how many high level boxers do you think are taking performance enhancing drugs? And I think, if I'm wrong, correct me, but I think in the video he said 90%. Not 90%. I mean, if you're a guy in the gym training your fucking hardest and doing all your road work, and then you know this guy is really just getting injections up the arse, then...
Just up to the tit.
What do you do?
What do you do?
Would you fight him clean, thinking fucking potatoes and eggs are going to get you through it?
Mm-hmm.
What do you do?
You think to yourself, I'm already like 2 rounds down in front of the belt. Look
at Golovkin. Golovkin was running through people. Met Canelo, couldn't put a dent in him.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't put a dent in that kid. Probably thinking, what? And then he pops, so he understands why he couldn't put a dent, and then they have a rematch, he loses. I mean, what example is that?
It's crazy. It's crazy. And it's sad in a way, because I think even though you have people like Vada in there trying to do their bit, at the end of the day, like, do we really know for definite how, you know, genuine they are with regard to certain fighters? I mean, money talks at the end of the day. And when you have sanctioned bodies, like with Canelo, where the first thing the WBC say, and WBA I think as well,
yeah.
Oh, it's fine. Like, you don't have the WBC, well, you have the WBA as well coming out jumping the canal and be like, oh, it's clearly just, you know, contaminated meat. It's like, well, this is just...
What can you do?